So I think that sky's the limit for TDE.
Definitely.
You know, I don't think there's no ceiling on what they're doing.
Top Dawg Entertainment. Top Dawg.
Top Dawg, my Top Dawg brother, Top Dawg himself, us eating you out of house and home. We'll never forget that, taking these kids out of the projects, out of Compton, and putting them right here on this stage to be the best they can be. We'll never forget that.
The whole time he wanted to get me to do some music because he heard me on a mixtape with one of my homies, and he called me getting a haircut. He was like, what's up? Chopped it up. I mean, he just took me off the streets, man, put me in a studio, and I've been there ever since. That's, you know, dope. What I mean?
Yeah, man, Top is a funny but, like, amazing dude just as far as, like, the things that he's been able to accomplish.
He was there from the start of when I was trying to do what I was doing, and he'd give me a little advice on stuff that, you know, he was trying to do. So it was a constant conversation. If I had a question, I'd call him or whatever. The conversations just grew more with me and Top. Remember one day he was like, you know, he liked the way I think, like with my line work, I should just come over with him. And at the same time, I was reaching a limit with what I was doing. Cause like it couldn't go no further. Like we didn't have the means. We couldn't be at all the spots we needed to. Mm-hmm. So we literally had jobs that we had to pay for stuff. So that was like kind of killing us.
From being in Death Row and being on the outside looking at y'all, I think y'all are a better version of Death Row Records. And that's with no disrespect, that's with all respect, because once you look and you see somebody do it the right way, and then you see them do it the wrong way, and then you get a chance to do it your own way, then you're able to take the wrong out and do it the right way. That's why y'all been able to sustain for so long. You and Top Dawg, y'all some dope Top Dawg bosses the way y'all run y'all shit.
Top Dawg Entertainment.
Anthony was the oldest of seven, well respected, calm and collected. Laughing and joking made life easier. Hard times, mom on crack. A 4-year-old telling his nanny he needed her. His family history, pimping and banking. He was meant to be dangerous. Clacked him a grip and start slanking. 15, scraping up his jeans with quarter pieces. Dodger policeman working for his brick on me. Smart time hustler graduated to a brick on him. $10,000 out of for project housing. That's on the daily. Seen his first meal, 20 years old. Had a couple of babies.
Open them up. I hope y'all like these. Hold on, don't nobody rush. Everybody get it to the same time at the same time. A gift from me to y'all. From Big Cousin.
Don't do this to me. Oh my God.
Yes.
I like to say that I grew up in Watts, my dad grew up in Watts, and his mother grew up in Watts. So it's definitely deep-rooted within our family, a pride for our community. So just seeing my dad come forth and pay for so many people's scholarships, funerals, parties, all type of different things within the community, it really brings me joy inside because he's become a big brother to the whole entire community.
Had a couple of shooters, caught a murder case. Fingerprints on the gun, they're assuming, but witnesses couldn't prove it. That was back when he turned his back and they killed his cousin. He beat the case and went back to hustling. Bird shuffling, Anthony rang. The first in the projects with the two-tone Mustang. That 5.0 thing, they say 5-0 came. Circling parking lots and parking spots and hopping out while harassing the corner blocks. Crooked cops told Anthony he should kick it. He brushed them off and walked back to the Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Duh. Top Dawg Entertainment.